So we've created a material we call tissue papers that's very thin, like phyllo dough, made up of biological tissues and organs. We can switch out the tissue that we use to make the tissue paper, so whether that be derived from liver or muscle or even ovary, we can switch it out very easily and make a paper out of any tissue or organ.
A lot of people don't want to buy kidneys, livers, or hearts to eat. So what the butchers do is just put them in bins in the corner for very cheap. And that's where we go and we collect our 5-10 hearts or 4 or 5 livers and kidneys. And that's what we use for the decel process to make tissue papers. So what this is showing is this heart piece here that's been decelled 1 day, 2 day, 3 day, 4 day, and 5 day. And you see it becomes cleared.
This is a cow ovary. So it's about the same size as a human ovary. After you take out all the cells and the water, this is what ovaries are like, and it's really what all our tissues and organs would be like. So we take our decellularized tissue or organ and we grind it into a fine powder. And it's that powder which we use to make the tissue papers.
Because it has components that are found in natural tissues and organs, the cells will recognize it once it's implanted.
What I've learned working here at Northwestern a lot, especially in conjunction with Feinberg, working with a lot of surgeons, is that they care about how materials feel and handle. So as I was picking this up, I'm like, I like how this feels. It handles nice, it's made of bioactive materials, there could be something here.
Ultimately, we'd want to create some type of patch or a very sophisticated band-aid in order to regenerate damaged parts.
The follicle cells or the ovarian cells grew very well on it. And they were able to produce estrogen. And so we think using this material in combination with those ovarian cells could restore estrogen function.
It really expands what we can do when it comes to creating synthetic environments or synthetic materials for tissue engineering applications.